Students, let's continue learning about some more brass instruments, and I thought we'd start with the biggest one right here, which is the tuba. Actually, technically, this is called a sousaphone, because there's two types of tubas. There's regular tubas, which look like a giant baritone, kind of like this, but a lot bigger. And there's the sousaphone. And the tuba came first, but the sousaphone came second because they wanted to have them in marching bands and military bands too. And it's hard to lug a big, humongous, imagine bigger than this, tuba around. Instead, they made it this shape so you could wear it and walk around with it. So they shaped it with this hole in the middle so people could wear it just like this. And then they had the lead pipe and then the mouthpiece. Like this, where you can keep adding these, which are called bits, and if we look really close, you just add more and more and more. Kind of like Legos or Kinects, if people still play with Kinects. Until you get the right length for your mouth, depending on how tall or how close you are to right here, the sweet part. And here at Soulsbyville, we only have sousaphone. Because we do marching here. We play a parade and we do the band review. Therefore, our tuba players are gonna have to wear something and march around with it. So we have sousaphones. But if you play this and you keep playing into high school and college, you get to play on tubas as well. And we'll see a video later, you can see what a tuba looks like. Remember, tuba, this is a sousaphone, but they play exactly the same. They're just shaped different. So they're the same instrument, they play the same. A tuba player can play a sousaphone just like the tuba. Same thing, different shape. Some tuba players think they have a little bit of a different sound, but same instrument. So we look at, do you see any similarities between this and the trumpet? Well, it has three vowels, just like on the trumpet, which also had three vowels right up on the top. And we push those down to make different sounds. So we push down vowels to make different sounds, and we also use our lips, just like on trumpet, to make different sounds, and trombone. No vowels. And it depends how loose or tight you are, how high or low you are. And let's look at the mouthpieces. Here's that trumpet mouthpiece. Here is the tuba mouthpiece, which is a lot bigger. So it covers most of your mouth, like this. And therefore, we vibrate our lips much more loosely than the trumpet. Underneath this mouthpiece, it looks like this. So when I play it, we play really low notes because it's a big instrument. We have really loose lips when we play. Low notes. And that means this is our bass instrument in the band. And bass instruments make the whole band sound better. Any band you think of has bass instruments in it. Whether it's bass guitar, or a tuba, or a big old string bass, they make the entire band sound really good. I like to describe it as if you were cooking up your favorite meal. Last night I made tortillas and eggs, and I put some pepper and some salt and some Italian seasoning in it. If you just cooked up your eggs and your tortillas but didn't add seasoning, it'd be all right. It tastes like eggs and tortillas, but when you add seasoning to food, it makes it taste really good. And that's what these bass instruments do. So we always need a lot of tuba players here at the Soulsbyville, band. I love it when people play this because it makes everybody in the whole band sound better. You guys are the seasoning. You make the whole band really pop. And it's really fun to play. And on top of that, you get a special chair when you play, and it looks like this. Because this thing can be a little heavy, people get a special chair that they sit in, and it holds the whole weight of the tuba. So you sit on that chair, and it holds it for you. That way, you can just play. You don't have all the weight on you. So this is our brass instrument. That is the lowest of the band, the bass instrument, the tuba. Why don't we see some professionals playing it?
Students, this is a college band, the LSU Drumline and Tubas, and we like to combine drum and bass a lot. You probably heard that genre, drum and bass. Well, this is them going around campus and playing a bit, probably before a football game, if I was to imagine. They're all uniformed up, and we like to go play for the crowds. I was in a college marching band, and this was tons of fun, let me tell you, going to play for everybody around the college just like this. And we have our tubas right here. And remember, tubas, sousaphone, same thing. These things are technically sousaphones, but people call them tubas all the time, including me. So let's take a look at these tubas and drums. Man, that makes me miss college. But why don't we take a look at a brass band? They're called Lucky Chops. They're out of New York City, and this one features their bass player. He's playing, again, sousaphone. So why don't we take a look? We won't finish the whole thing because after a bit, it features the saxophone, and that's a woodwind. And we're going to learn about woodwinds on another lesson. So here we go, Lucky Chops, and this is the song Booyo.
We'll be right back.
like I said, that starts featuring the saxophone more. He's playing a Barry sax, and this will be a different lesson. This is performer Leo P., and we'll learn a little bit, probably get some videos of him in our sax video. But I think we need to move to another brass instrument. Let's end this on tuba, and let's move on to baritone.
Next up, we've got the baritone. Looks like this. It's like the big brother of the trumpet. But instead of playing it out like this, you play it, here's that mouthpiece, but they do make some marching band versions of the baritone where it is just like a giant trumpet where you hold it like this, vowels are on top, and then the mouthpiece would be right here. You play it like that. So baritone's obviously a lot bigger. Looks like this. And just like with the trumpet, there's the cornet, which is kind of the smaller version, and the trumpet, which is the longer version. We've got baritones, and the same thing, it has another name though, the euphonium. Ooh, and this one's extra shiny, right? The euphoniums are usually a little bigger, and a lot of the time they'll have a fourth vowel, which that's the same as doing the combination of one and three. Because sometimes when you're playing these brass instruments, some combos between notes might be hard one and three, but it might be easy with the pinky four. So we got the euphonium and the baritone. You can see the baritone's a little bit smaller, but it's the same thing. So I'm going to play a little bit of euphonium for you so you can hear what it sounds like. Big brother of the trumpet, so obviously it's what's called one octave lower. So here is our trumpet. Here's the same note, but lower, right? All right, let's play a little euphonium for you. Baritone, euphonium, same thing. Mostly a woodwind player. Well, why don't we take a look at the euphonium? You'll notice it's just like the trumpet. It's one big long tube. They just wrapped it around and around. You can see where the mouthpiece is. Comes in and goes through the valve casing. Comes out here. Wraps around and whoop, whoop, whoop. Comes out the bell, which is awful big. Now here at Soulsbyville, I've got small baritones for beginners, like in fifth grade. I've got these big baritones for when you get to about seventh grade and eighth grade and get a lot taller. They all sound the same. It's just how they are wrapped up to make the right length and the right diameter to make the right sound. So about this big on me, awful fun to play. And just like the trumpet, it has the valves that can come out, these slides that come out, and everything else. Bigger means lower, so I can get awful low on this thing. And since we're playing the low notes in the band, we're a tenor. That means we're lower, much lower than the trumpet. Trumpet's the high notes, the baritone and euphonium are the low notes. So you're playing a lot of bass lines, you're playing a lot of the beautiful low notes in a concert band. Why don't we look at these two mouthpieces, because that changes how you buzz your lips. So on the trumpet, we've got a really tight buzz. But look how much bigger the euphonium and the baritone mouthpieces. It takes up this much slow up in your lip. So it's a much looser buzz. More like that. Whereas trumpet is. Check it out. I'm gonna do the same thing that I did on the trumpet. gonna buzz, and then I'm gonna put it onto the instrument so you can hear it. And just like all the other brass instruments, I can control it with my fingers. And I can control it with my lips. All about how tight your buzz is to make those different notes. Euphonium, baritone, same thing. Just different names for how they're shaped, but they play exactly the same. An extremely fun low instrument.
So let's look at some pros playing these baritones and euphoniums. This is, they called themselves the Quarantine Quartet, because this is right when the pandemic started, and they had to stay separate from everybody else, so they said, hey, why don't we just play us, the five of us, four of us, quartet means four. Let's take a look.
Hi, we're Quarantine, and today we're going to play Super Mario Brothers, the main theme. One, two.
That's beautiful. I love the baritone, that low sound, but you can tell they can also play high notes as well. Nice, smooth, round sound. But I believe it's time. Why don't we move on to our last one?
All right, students, let's talk about our last brass instrument, the French horn. And I talked about it a couple lessons ago, so I'll talk about it pretty briefly. And this is our hardest of the brass instruments. I don't let students try this brass instrument out until they've played 2 years on one of those that I showed you earlier, the trumpet, the baritone, or the tuba. Because this one has the partials, that's the different notes you can play with just your lips. The partials are really close together. So it takes a really skillful brass player to navigate this thing. Let me give you an example. They're very close together. So really, we still have the hardness of pushing these vowels down, but now they're so close together, you have to be really discerning with your lips to be able to find those. Very fun instrument, has three vowels, just like all the other brass instruments. A very big bell. Remember when we watched that other one, you can change the sound by how far in your hand is in the bell. So I'm going to have it open, close, open. You get a very different sound. Remember all those partials are close together, so you can do fun stuff like... beautiful instrument. I'm not a good French horn player, because I think I said in the last video I play it once every like 2 or 3 years. But why don't I give it a try? Hardest of the brass instruments, but I love it. It's a beautiful instrument. And now that you've heard the not professional play, let's hear a professional play.
Lastly, students, let's see what all these brass instruments combined can sound like in a brass quintet. It's 5 different brass instruments playing together. So let's conclude our look at all the family of brass with all its instruments in it with a brass quintet. And we'll be looking at the most famous brass quintet, the Canadian Brass. These guys are famous for being excellent brass musicians, and they're playing the famous song, Flight of the Bumblebee. Thank you. cool, guys. We'll end there, but I did promise you you'd see a tuba by the end of this lesson. That's what a tuba looks like. It's like a big giant baritone, right? Well, we'll have to move on to a new instrument family since we've covered all five that you can play here at Soulsbyville. So tune in next time. We will look at another instrument family. See you guys in the next one.